and welcome to Life Lessons with the Reading School District. I'm Kristen Boyd, Director of Community Engagement. Today, we have Erica Evans-Lose. She's an art teacher at Lawrence Park Elementary. I'm going to let her introduce herself and just tell us a little bit about your background.
Hi, I'm Erica Evans-Lose, and I've actually been teaching in the Reading School District, I can't believe it, for 17 years. I always knew I wanted to be an art teacher from an early age. I had a great aunt that was an art teacher in Berks County, and I kind of think that she inspired me to want to be an artist. I think that I've been drawing and doing art since a very early age. I went to a small rural school, grew up in a farming community, although I'm not a farmer. And when I graduated from high school, I ended up going to Kutztown University. And while I was there, I was able to work as a playground leader in the summer for the recreation department. And I ended up staying on as their art director. And that really inspired me to want to work in urban education. I really knew that I always wanted to work in a city school. I student taught in Reading School District, and I'm just really glad that I'm here.
I think it's so ironic that you mentioned the Reading Rec Commission in the playground. My sister, who's a teacher in the district, also did that. And I remember the cool projects that we would put together for the Lantern Parade.
Yes, yes.
And that was one of my favorite things as a kid growing up. I still remember what we did for Willy Wonka in the Chocolate Factory. So I didn't realize that about you. So it's just cool to have that artistic memory kind of pop back up when you talked about that. So for you, from your childhood, what's one of those memories that you have where just art really connected with you?
I guess growing up, we weren't watching TV a lot. My mom really pushed us to read and drawing, and that was something that I just really liked to do. In the city, you're lucky because you can walk right down the street and visit your friends. But growing up in a rural community, you are kind of on your own, the closest people you have to drive to see. So at home, I did a lot of drawing and creating artwork.
What did you like to draw? Did you kind of have a specialty when you were a kid? Like mine was bubble letters.
I like to design actually architecture.
Oh, wow.
And I also like to create clothing. And when I was in high school, I actually designed my own prom dress because I just thought it would be really fun to do.
It's like Very Pretty in Pink of you.
Yes.
Do you remember that movie?
Yes.
What it sounds like. So tell us about art in your classroom now. What are you trying to accomplish when you go to school each day and connect with the kids?
Well, one of the things I love to do is travel, and I love learning new things, reading about history, and I love to impart that to my students. Mm-hmm. I think it's very important to make connections to other subjects, but also connect it to cultures and art history. So I really try to do that with my students every day.
I know there was one thing you just did, which was an exhibit at Goggleworks.
Uh-huh.
How does that make you feel when, you know, even as an art teacher, you still have an opportunity to express yourself?
I guess it's one of the things that, you know, I always tell my students, you know, practice what you preach. If I'm going to tell you that you need to practice doing your drawing or practice your reading, I need to do that as well. And by doing that exhibit at the Goggleworks, I felt like I was showing my students, you know what, you can do art. I do art on my own, and that's really important to follow through with.
So for you, why do you think art is important? What sort of impact do you see it having either in your own life or in your students' lives?
Well, I think it's a great way to communicate, and especially around the world, because art is such a, you know, we're in such a visual culture. So for people to go to different countries and see art and build relationships with people, that's very important to me.
Absolutely.
And I guess one of the other things I hope is that I inspire my students and their families to go out into the community and visit places like the Goggleworks and feel comfortable going to places like the Reading Public Museum, because we see art every day even though we don't realize it.
Mm-hmm. Tell us about your art club. I always think this is such a cool idea, and the passion that you bring to it has always impressed me. So just tell us a little bit about that and how that came about.
Well, on Wednesdays, you can usually catch me after school with my art club students. Every year for the past 4 years, we've been doing a Valentine's for Veterans program, and with the families and the students, we create Valentine cards and send them to the local veterans hospital. So I think being part of the community and doing volunteer work is something very important to share with my students. And every year we try to pick a very interesting, crazy kind of project to either install in the school or display. And this year we're working on recycling and repurposing. So we've been taking what other people might think is junk and creating a Louise Nevelson sculpture out of it that we're finishing up right now.
Tell us about some of the previous projects. You said you do this every year.
Yeah.
What else have you done?
If you come into the school lobby of Lowrys Park, you'll see all these heads that the students sculpted. Mm-hmm. And we put lights in them so they kind of light up. They're very interesting. And other years we've made different sculptures. There's projects hanging in the windows. So it's neat that they get to carry on a piece of their artwork even after they leave.
They kind of have that legacy, which is something that Mr. Hudak has instilled in that school.
Absolutely.
So for you, I know there's one other thing you do, and that's your summer program. Is that similar to your art club, or is that, how's that work?
It's similar, but I always like a challenge and I get bored. So last year I decided, you know what, I'm going to invite parents and students to make art together. And I think that's really important, mm-hmm. to reach out to the community and also make people feel comfortable about creating art, because absolutely. I hear a lot of parents say, oh, I can't draw, or I'm not very good at art. I want people to feel confident and comfortable doing it. So that was kind of a different take on it. It was kind of neat hearing, you know, parents' perspectives and seeing them challenge themselves. Mm-hmm. And then at the end of our week, we actually had a little art show and invited the extended family to come and see their
artwork.
That's
so cool. And I know one of the things Erica helped me with was our sidewalk chalk drawing, which we're trying to do at the beginning of every school year.
Right.
I'm kind of the welcome kids back. And so to reach out to Erica and have her say yes, she came in on the Sunday night before the first day of school, made drawings for those kids at Lowrys Park so they would see them and feel great and welcomed when they came back. I just think it shows your dedication to not only art, but the students at your school. So we appreciate that.
Thank you.
Absolutely.
Thank you.
Well, thank you for joining us today, talking a little bit about art. Is there anything else you would want to add? Do you want people to know about you or how art kind of influences your everyday?
I just want everyone to know that you can do it no matter what. I always say that to my students. I can't is not in my vocabulary. You know, I'll say to them, you can do it no matter what, or I like to say in my Spanish accent, si se puede, and you can do it. So just remember, whatever you put your mind to, never, never, ever give up.
Sounds good. Well, thank you again for joining us. We are very happy to have Erica here to talk about art. We hope you join us next time on Life Lessons from the Reading School District. Have a great day.
Hi, I'm here at the People Chronicles. My name is Erica Evans-Lose. I'm an art teacher at Lowrys Park Elementary School and Reading School District. It's great that we're able to share our stories to inspire other people here at the People Chronicles. Follow us on Facebook. And remember, to all the students out there, never ever give up. And remember, si se puede, you can do it.